and welcome to a new MAHLE vlog. This time we are in Hockenheim for the Formula Student Germany. And MAHLE is one of the main sponsors of the event, and that's why we can give you exclusive insights. So we follow two teams and we have a very special guest for the weekend. It's the former DTM champion and Formula E driver Gary Paffett. So follow me, guys. So I'm going to give you a short explanation of the whole concept of the Formula Student. While there are students from all over the world who build single-seat Formula race cars and they compete against each other in different disciplines. And it's just incredible to see those teams from all over the world here in Hockenheim at the Formula Student Germany. There are more than 100 teams attending the competitions. This is just insane. And you can't win this competition just by having the fastest car. No, it's all about the overall package. So you also have to win in those disciplines like construction, performance, financial and sales planning. And it's really good for the students because they really take the extra mile in their education and it really opens doors for them.
Hi. Good, and you?
Fine.
Good. Hi.
Hi, nice to meet you.
Hi, how are you?
Hi guys, so I've already told you that we have a very special guest today and it's Gary Paffett, former DTM champion and Formula E driver for HWA Wrocław. And this is Magnus, he's one of the drivers of the green team here, right?
Yes,
that's true. So, Gary, what's your first impression? I mean, you've been already walking around here in the paddock and you've seen some teams. What's your impression of the Formula Student?
It's incredible. I mean, when you look at the cars, you know, close up, they're like mini Formula One cars. You know, the technology is incredible. For students to be doing this all themselves, and it's just amazing to see. You know, they look great cars to drive. They look like, you know, I used to drive cars when I was younger, go karts when I was younger. They look like, you know, bigger, faster, much more complicated versions of them. So they look incredibly fun to drive, and yeah, it's really impressive.
Yeah, so Magnus, you've already shown him the car and he already sat in the car, which is really awesome. So what's your feeling in the car? How different is it to your normal Formula E car?
Yeah, very different. It's very small, yeah, obviously.
Yeah, really?
But it's like I said, it feels like a car, like a go-kart, but just obviously it's bigger, it's faster, it's made of carbon fiber, so it's quite different. But it's it's really compact, really lightweight. You know, they told me the weight of the car, they're really light, so it's going to be really nimble. So they're impressive, you know, but it does feel like a mini Formula One car, basically.
Yeah, yeah. Very cool. So Marcus, would you like to drive professionally?
Yeah, I guess I would, yeah. I think it's a little bit too late, but it was also something where I got into Formula One just because I love driving, and maybe some opportunities open up for some club racing, something small GT series.
Yeah, maybe. But would you really say it's too late already? So maybe you can answer that question. Is it too late for him to start it professionally?
I don't know. I think it's never really too late, but it's harder to get in. When you're younger, you get kind of reputation as you go through. So it's about finding an opportunity. If you get an opportunity, then you can go and prove yourself and stuff. So it's never really too late. Obviously, the later you start, the more difficult it is. But you know, I know drivers. I know certainly a guy that I raced against, Maxime Martin, who races in GTs and DTM. I mean, I don't think he started racing until he was 16 or something.
Really?
So yeah, so he started very late. So it's like I say, it's definitely never too late. But
yeah.
If you want to do it, then yeah, just keep
going.
Just
go for it. Yeah,
exactly. Yeah.
So would you encourage your kids to take part in those competitions like Formula Student?
Absolutely, yeah. Yeah, absolutely. I mean, it's an incredible thing, and it gives you an incredible insight into the technology of motorsport. You know, the technology in these cars is incredible. Yeah, very similar to what we're looking at in Formula E and Formula One, things like this. And yeah, the aerodynamics, the way the cars are built and put together is like the cars that we race professionally. So it's you know, fantastic groundwork for people wanting to either become drivers or certainly become engineers in top motorsport. Yeah.
Yeah, absolutely. Yeah. So guys, thank you so much for your time. Thank you, Marcus, and thank you, Gary.
Thank you.
So see you guys later.
Hi, I'm Marcus, driver of the green team in Stuttgart, and today I'm going to give you a quick overview about our steering wheel. So on the top, the two buttons are for the switching of the pages from the display, and if you press them simultaneously and release them, you have a launch control for the acceleration. Then the right one in the middle is a marker button for the driver if he notices something during driving, and if you both press both buttons in the middle, you have a control unit restart in case anything goes wrong. Then beneath that you have two rotary switches, one for the torque vectoring system where you can set it to a lower standard or raise it a little bit if you want more pull around the corners, and the right one is for the balance front to rear with our all-wheel drive. The right one on the bottom is for the cooling system, so if you want to restart the pumps while driving you can do it there.
So hi MAHLE fans, I'm here at the Formula Student Germany, just having a look at these amazing cars, seeing something around the track here and having a great time. So I hope any of you are here, you're enjoying it as well.
So the next part will be in German, just follow the subtitles below. Ich stehe jetzt hier mit Raphael und Raphael arbeitet bei unserem Corporate Startup ChargeBig. Raphael, kannst du uns mal ganz kurz erklären, worum geht's bei ChargeBig?
Aber na klar. ChargeBig ist ein Corporate Startup, bezieht sich auf Ladesäulen. Das heißt, wir möchten hochskalierbare Ladeinfrastruktur herstellen und auch unseren Kunden bereitstellen, dass man über 20, 30 Ladepunkte bei sich in der Firma installieren kann und so seine Elektrofahrzeuge laden kann.
Okay, was ist denn genau dein Job? Was machst du bei ChargeBig?
Ich bin für die Softwareentwicklung verantwortlich. MAHLE hat seinen eigenen Ladecontroller entwickelt, ist gerade mit der Generation 1 fertig und jetzt sind wir in der Entwicklung von Generation 2. Und anhand von diesem Controller können wir die Kommunikation mit dem Fahrzeug aufbauen und so das Starten des Ladevorgangs herstellen.
Ja, wie viele Leute seid ihr denn bei ChargeBig?
Aktuell sind wir zu sechs im Team.
Nur?
Ja.
Okay.
Wir müssen aber dringend unser Team erweitern. Aktuell sind wir im Vertrieb mit einer Person vorhanden. Wir haben jemanden für die Fördermittel und aktuell sind wir auch für die Entwicklung insgesamt nur zwei Personen. Und so kommt es eben, dass wir jetzt auch aktuell Stellen suchen und hoffen, dass wir unser Team auch erweitern können.
Welche Vorteile bietet ChargeBig?
ChargeBig hat einen großen Vorteil, dass es ein sehr dynamisches Lastmanagement hat. Das heißt, wir können die Fahrzeuge zwischen 2,3 und 7,2 kW laden. Das heißt, wenn aktuell mehr Leistung an Trafo anliegt, können wir die Fahrzeuge auch schneller laden. Es gibt auch die Möglichkeit, dass wenn der Kunde sich das wünscht, dass wir auch 22 kW Ladepunkte aufstellen. Die gehen dann ungeregelt in den Betrieb. Das heißt, da können die Fahrzeuge dann relativ schnell aufgeladen werden.
Ja, cool. So, jetzt sind wir ja hier bei der Formula Student. Wie findest du denn das Event? Wie sind so deine Eindrücke? Was machst du hier den ganzen Tag und wie gefällt dir?
Ja, also ich war mein erster Besuch hier bei Formula Student, ja. Und doch, es war sehr interessant. Also vor allem der Punkt ist, dass eben sehr viele Studenten hier sind. Ist auch für uns ziemlich interessant, da wir aktuell Stellen suchen und auch nicht abgeneigt sind, Absolventen einzustellen. Hat es doch sehr einen guten Eindruck gemacht. Ja, gut ab, was die Jungs hier leisten. Und Mädels natürlich.
Das darf man nicht vergessen. Das finde ich nämlich auch ziemlich cool. Danke, Raphael, für deine Zeit.
Kein Problem.
Ich würde sagen, wir sehen uns nachher wieder. So we call it a day. It's been an incredible weekend here at Formula Student Germany. We made some really cool experiences, met some great people such as Gary Paffett or all the members here of the different teams that we support. And I would say if you have any questions left, just leave them below. And I really hope that you enjoyed the vlog, and thank you guys so much for watching. See you next time around.